Real-life motorcycle racing is fast and extremely exciting. Generally, video game motorcycle racing captures the same excitement. Unfortunately, Suzuka 8 Hours from Namco did not live up to that standard. Suzuka gives you several options to choose from: practice, time trial, race tour, and two-player modes. Both practice and time trial modes are not highly competitive, but are perfect for getting acquainted with the controls before entering the tour. Suzuka 8 Hours has 5 different race courses and different time selections as well. The races are all held on closed circuits and range from terribly easy to mighty difficult. Bike setup includes several options that make a big difference when used correctly. You can choose a bike that excels in acceleration, top speed, or cornering. A wise choice is often found in the cornering package. You can also choose either an automatic or manual transmission, and you can change your bike's color. The two-player race mode has a top and bottom split-screen arrangement. The screen was filled with gameplay, not borders, which was space used well. The game had no traditional slowdown in either one- or two-player mode. Several bikes are on the track other than you and your opponent during two-player mode, but the only competition is your human opponent. Race Tour mode is the basis of the game. Starting in the 250cc class, you can move your way to the top by advancing through the classes, which isn't as difficult as it sounds. To advance, you must meet or exceed a point limit which can be accumulated over the Race Tour segments. The feel of speed was not fully translated into this game. Traveling at speeds in excess of 200 miles per hour felt the same as 20 miles per hour. That lack of movement takes away any sense that you're playing a high-speed game.